are going to discuss about secondary storage devices. The secondary memory is also called auxiliary memory or external memory. It is not fixed inside the CPU. Today we are going to discuss the devices like hard disk, CD, DVD, pen drive, magnetic tape, floppy disk, memory cards, etc. So dear students, let us continue our chapter.
Dear students, let us continue our second chapter, memory and storage. Today we are going to discuss about secondary memory. Secondary memory is also known as auxiliary memory or external memory. It is not located inside the CPU. They are used to store the data and information for a long time. In secondary memory, information remains stored till the user erases it. Some commonly used secondary memory devices are floppy disk, hard disk, CD or DVD, flash disk, etc. So secondary memory is also called auxiliary memory or external memory. It is not located inside the CPU and it is used to store data and information for a long time, and the information remains stored till the user erases it. The first secondary memory we are going to discuss is hard disk. The hard disk is an inbuilt storage medium. That is, whenever we purchase a CPU, the hard disk is inbuilt on it and it is fixed inside the CPU, and it has large capacity on which we can store large amount of data. All the programs and data of a computer are stored in it. When we start a computer, the hard disk starts reading the information necessary to start the computer. The hard disk can store up to 2 TB, that is 2 TB of data. So hard disk is a secondary storage device. It is an inbuilt storage medium. It is fixed inside the CPU and it have a large storage capacity. The next secondary memory is floppy disk. It is a storage medium which is used to move data from one computer to another, like a CD or DVD. And it is a magnetic disk covered with a thin plastic plate, and it is easy to carry anywhere and easy to work on. Nowadays, this is not popular in use. The size of floppy is 3.5 inch and it stores up to 1.44 MB data. So a floppy disk is a secondary storage media. It is used to move data from one computer to another, and usually it is easy to carry to anywhere. And then the next storage device is compact disk or CD. It is a thin plastic disk coated with a metal, and it is a high capacity storage device that stores large amount of information up to 700 MB. So a compact disk or CD storage capacity is up to 700 megabyte. It can store text, graphics, pictures, music, videos, etc. A CD can hold a text or music, videos, pictures, etc. And it is a portable storage device. Why it is called portable? Portable means we can carry the secondary storage device from one place to another. We can store or move the data from one computer to another computer easily by using the CD. The next secondary memory is digital versatile disk or DVD. It is an optical storage device which reads data at a much faster speed than a CD. A single layer, that is single-sided DVD, can store data up to 4.7 gigabyte. That is around 6 times more than that of CD. And a double-sided, that is double-layer DVD, can store data up to 17.8 GB. That is around 25 times of the CD. So a DVD have much faster and have more storage capacity when we comparing with a compact disc or CD. The next secondary memory is magnetic tap. A magnetic tap is used for storing a large amount of data. A magnetic tap is a long magnetic coated plastic strip like a cassette in radios. It is housed in a plastic jacket. It is a common storage device on most of the mainframe computers and some personal computer. A magnetic tap has one clear limitation, that is, it is a sequential access medium. Why it is called sequential access medium? We can access data stored in the magnetic tap by in a sequential order, that is one after two, then three, four, like that. If we have to retrieve information from the middle of the tap, it is very time consuming. A magnetic tap is used today mostly for backup of data and for a few other operations that are not time sensitive. So magnetic tap is a secondary storage medium mainly used for backup data, and it have a limitation, that is it is a sequential access medium. We can only retrieve data in a sequential order, so it is more time consuming. The next type of secondary storage is multimedia card. It is a storage medium designed for portable devices like mobile and digital camera in a form that can easily be removed for access by a computer, just like a memory card. A multimedia card reader is used to insert the card and connect it to a computer through a USB cable. Most of the laptops come with inbuilt card reader. So multimedia is card like a memory card. It is mostly used in mobile phones, laptops or digital cameras. And a multimedia card reader is used to read data or store data into the multimedia card. Then the next type of secondary storage device is flash disk. It is popularly known as pen drive. It is a data storage device with a USB connector, that is a universal serial bus connector, is fixed in the flash disk. It is a portable storage device. Portable, we already discussed. Portable means we can move from one place to another. We can carry data from one place to another easily. And that can be connected and removed very easily with the CPU to store data in it. The storage capacity typically ranges from 128 MB to 32 GB and more. So a pen drive have large storage capacity than other secondary storage devices. We can easily transfer data from one place to another, and it have a USB port with it. The next type of secondary memory storage device is memory card. We are all familiar with memory card. Mostly it is used in mobile phones and digital camera. And a memory card reader is used to read and write data into a memory card. So a memory card is a storage media designed for portable devices like mobile and digital camera. It can be easily removed for access by a computer by placing in a card reader and connect it to a computer through a USB cable. So nowadays laptops come with inbuilt card readers. So dear students, today we discuss about the secondary memory. And the secondary memory is also called auxiliary memory or external memory. The main secondary memory devices are hard disk, floppy disk, compact disk, DVD, magnetic tape, memory card, flash disk, multimedia card. So dear students, please read your chapter very well, and you have a homework, that is please try to do the assessments in our chapter, that is in page number 19 and 20. Please try to do it and study well. Thank you. Have a nice day.